what all you'll be learning in that subjects. Like saying that, and what is the process, how to give the examination, how the exams has been conducted for the issuing of CPF, and whatever it is. And whenever if you are required to ask any question on the behalf, just let me know at that point only, so I can explain you in more detail about that, right? Theek hai? Anything else you need to ask me before starting this topic, Ali?
No.
And you can keep your mic on so that you don't have to keep on switching on the mic and all. So whenever we are communicating, it's better for both of us, right? Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Fine.
So can you give me an idea, like right now, what information you have, that what you need to do for the CPL, what all subjects? Do you have any idea about that?
Yes, it has 6 subjects for CPL exam.
Okay, great. So I'll just give you a brief idea in all the 6 subjects, what are the subjects and what you'll be learning in that, and what all classes, how many time of class you need to require so that you can able to conduct examination, you can clear it in once, like in the one chance only, and you would be able to understand it very nicely. So like to issue a CPL license, the issuing authority is the Director General of Civil Aviation, which is the DGCA, and this authority is responsible to take the examination also for all the CPL students. Now, for conducting a CPL, there are basically like 6 subjects, which is the technical general, you should be knowing, the general navigation, meteorology, air regulations, radio telephone, which is the RTR, and the specific. So this all subjects that are required to clear an examination. So collectively, when you are done with your all the 6 subjects and you are done with your flying of 200 hours, togetherness, you will submit you all the documents to the DGCA, and then they will issue a CPL to you. Now, what is the technical general? In technical general, what you'll be learning is like basically the specification of the aircraft engine, that is the piston engine, jet engine, how this piston engine, jet engine works. Then the what is the principle of flight? The topic that includes in the technical general is the principle of flight, how the aircraft fly technically in the theoretical papers. How the aircraft fly, what all laws are applied on that. So you will be learning that in the principle of flight. Then the aircraft systems. Now in the aircraft system, after building the aircraft, understanding the engines, what all aircraft is equipped with, saying that what are the emergency equipments in the aircraft, what are the oxygen system is there in the aircraft. So how they work, that all we'll understand in this topic, which is the aircraft system. And the electrical, how the aircraft operate with the electrical things, what all current has been given to the aircraft, which is the AC or the DC. So basic information you'll be understanding. So this is what the technical general is. Now to complete this chapter, this technical general, where you have 5 topics including, would require around every day 3 hours lecture, and up till around 50 lectures you'd be requiring with the hours of 3 hours lecture. So that much duration you would be required to complete this whole technical general, which is okay. Around 50 days. And 3 hours lecture every day. So that would be like with the weeks off and all, everything including 50 days. So this is what technical general is. Then the general navigation. Now general navigation is the subject where you will be learning how the aircraft navigate from one point to another, and what all calculations you'll be doing. Now in this subject, now you are required to learn many numericals in it, which are very easier. How they go from one place to another with time. And so we can calculate the distance with the time distance relationship. And then regarding that, there are a lot of calculations in that. Then that would be included in this general navigation thing. In this general navigation topic, where you'll be navigating from one place to another, how you'll be navigating, what all calculations you'd be required to do, and everything regarding that would be in the general navigation. Then is the instruments. Now, what all instruments are used in the aircraft system and how they work and how they are applied in the navigation purpose, that you'll be understanding in the general navigation. Then is the radio aids. Now, in the radio aids, you would be getting to know and learn about how radio navigation, like we know that the aircraft communicate from one place to another or to the ground station with the help of radio aids. Now, there are a lot